Here we can see the problem is given in terms of its complementary angle. So we can use it that when we are converting sine to cos, instead of the angle we have to take the complement of that angle. Okay, and by using this we can now use here the identity cos square theta plus sine square theta plus cos square theta, that is equal to 1. Here also you can use sine square theta plus cos square theta, that is equal to 1. And you are going to get here answer 1. Now in this question we can take out 9 common, and we can see here sec square a minus tan square a, that is nothing but the identity 1 plus tan square a is equal to sec square a. If you are going to carry this tan square to another side, we will get sec square a minus tan square a, that is equal to 1, and that only we have kept it here. Now in this type of the problem is given in terms of tan sec, cot and cosec. The easy way for doing this problem, to solve this problem, that we can convert each trigonometric ratios in the simple form, that is in cos and sine form. So tan means we have written sine divided by cos, sec means 1 by cos, cot means cos divided by sine, and say cosec means 1 divided by sine. Now here we can see the cos theta, we can take out the common denominator, whereas here sine theta is the common denominator. Okay, if you want to take the common denominator as cos theta, nothing we have multiplied here, nothing we have multiplied here, but we should multiply to the numerator and denominator by cos theta. So this term only will change, these two will be as it is, similar here. So now we are going to get here the problems in such a way that now we can use the identity there, that is a plus b into a minus b, that is equal to a square minus b square. We are going to assume that cos theta plus sine theta, it is a single term, one term plus another term, this is one term minus the another term. And hence we can use this identity. After using the identity, the square of the first term minus the square of the second term. Now we will get here after solving this bracket. Okay, cos square theta plus sine square theta, that is nothing but equal to 1. Okay, and here already minus 1 was there, and this we got after solving the squaring of a bracket. So now we are going to get here 1 minus 1, that will be 0, and 2 cos theta into sin theta divided by sin theta into cos theta, that is equal to 2. Now in third case also you can convert that other trigonometric ratios in terms of cos theta and sin theta, and you can solve it further.